Hey everyone, it's Christine with Mission Yoga. Thanks for tuning in for another online class. So we'll just give everybody about another minute to join in, get your mat set up, get a block, get water, whatever you need to. Hop over to my mat and get myself settled as well. Today we'll be flowing through 60 minutes of just an all levels vinyasa class. So just like with every other vinyasa class, the focus is on linking your breath with your movement. And please take this at your own pace. So if I cue anything that just isn't in the cards for you today, or isn't part of your practice, modify it, variation that works better for you or feels better for you today. This is truly your practice and I want you. So start at the back of your mat and find your child's pose. Toes together, knees are wide. Relax your upper body onto the mat and begin to deepen your breath. Starting to establish a nice smooth rhythm that will carry you through your practice. Allow the sound of your breath to begin to clear your mind to any thoughts outside of the room, outside of the mat, and outside of your practice. Bringing your focus to the present. Taking three more deep breaths. Pressing the palms into the mat, and a little bit closer to the heels. Feel the lengthening through the spine. One more breath in. Exhale, completely empty out. Begin to bring a little bit of movement to your child's pose. So maybe rocking side to side, wiggling the hips, moving the forehead on the mat. And then walk your fingertips over the left. Maybe the right hand over the left hand. Getting a stretch of the right side body. Breathing into that space. Back through center and switching sides, walking the hands over to the right. Maybe taking the left palm on the right hand and breathe into that space you're creating in the left side body. Keeping the hips pressing towards the heels. Walk it back through center, child's pose, take one. Slowly make your way to tabletop, hands and knees hip-width distance apart, shoulders over the wrists, toes can be tucked or untucked, warming up the spine with a few cats and cows. On an inhale, drop the belly, lift the gaze, tailbone up, exhale, round and curl away from you, inhale, look up, tailbone lifts.
stability, building your foundation. From here, bending that back knee, either staying right here, or you can take a half bind, wrapping around the low back, or full bind, reaching for the top of the foot. Good. If you're full bind, you really kick the palm, creating resistance. Take one more breath. Good. Slowly releasing whatever variation you have in this pose, and returning to tabletop on all fours. Resetting and flowing into the other side. Kicking the right leg straight behind you as if you're gonna press a footprint on that wall. Left arm extends, thumb to the ceiling, engage the core. Lift through that back leg, strong and engaged. Breathe. And bend that back knee like you're gonna put the footprint on the ceiling this time. And either take that half bind or full bind. Opening up the shoulder. Create that resistance with the palm and with the top of the foot if you're full binding. Half binding, just keep pressing up to the ceiling with the sole of the foot. One more breath. And gently release, forward and back first, and meeting up in tabletop, taking one round of cat and cow to rinse that out. Inhale, exhale, round and curl. Exhale, tuck the toes and find your first downward facing dog, lifting the hips to the ceiling, pressing the heels towards the mat. Take a couple breaths here, and just feeling out your first down dog, taking whatever stretches you do to warm up. Maybe pedaling the feet, alternating bending the knees, shaking the head yes and no, wiggle the hips. Becoming aware of where you may feel some tightness, some resistance. And also where you're feeling some space and some mobility. And being able to work with both of those today. Inhale, toes, the arches of the feet. Exhale, lower heels to the mat. Inhale, up onto the toes. Exhale, lower the heels. Inhale, up onto the toes and roll forward to high plank. Exhale, downward facing dog, lower heels. One more like that. Inhale, up onto the toes, forward to plank. Exhale, lift the hips, lower the heels, downward facing dog. Inhale, sweep right leg to the ceiling. Exhale, bend at the knee, hip up and over, opening up the hip. Keeping the palms pressed into the mat, shoulders stay square. One more breath. Good. Release it, extending right leg to the ceiling. And then lowering back down. Downward facing dog. Switching sides with your breath on your inhale. Left leg sweeps up. Exhale, bending at the knee. Taking it up and over, opening up that hip. Breathe, press into the palms, keep the shoulders square. One more breath. And release it, three-legged dog, all the way down to downward facing dog. Inhale, up onto the toes. Exhale, bend the knees, look to the hands, and baby step your feet to your hands at the top of your mat, and find ragdoll. Separating your feet at least hip-width distance apart. Inhale to a flat, set up. Exhale, folding forward, and take opposite hands, opposite elbows, just hang out for a few breaths here. Tailbone to the ceiling. come from the hips. Head is completely heavy, neck relaxed. Two more breaths here. Drop the fingertips to the mat. Heel, toe, feet together. Inhale, halfway lift, flat back. Exhale, forward fold. Inhale, slowly roll yourself up to standing. Reach the arms, head, take your time. Exhale, bring the hands to heart center. Taking three breaths here in your Tadasana Mountain Pose and set an intention for yourself for your practice today. Whatever you need, just invite it in and ask for it. Release the hands, palms on your sides, facing forward. Inhale, sweep up, reach up. Exhale, forward fold. Warming up with some sun salutation A's. Inhale, halfway lift. Exhale, plant the palms, step it back, high plank. We'll modify first. Exhale, drop the knees, the chest, and the chin, keeping the seat high, elbows close together. Inhale, lift the upper body, baby cobra. Exhale, toes, and make your way to facing dog. Breathe. And modified version is always available for you. And so is skipping vinyasas, right in downward facing dog. Inhale, come up onto the toes. Exhale, bend the knees, look to the hands, step or hop to the top of the mat. Inhale, halfway lift, flat back. Exhale, forward fold. Inhale, slowly reach up. Arms overhead. Exhale, hands to heart. One more. Inhale, sweep up, reach. Exhale, forward fold. Inhale, half lift. Exhale, plant the palms, step or jump back and lower down, either knees, chest, chin, or chaturanga dandasana. Inhale, forward and through, upward facing dog or baby cobra pose. Exhale, lift the hips, downward facing dog. Breathe. Inhale, up onto the toes. Exhale, bend the knees, look forward, step or hop, top of the mat. Inhale, half lift. Exhale, fold forward. Inhale, rise up to stand, reach the arms overhead, palms press. Exhale, hands to heart center. Good, sun salutation B. Inhale, sweep up, bend the knees, sit your seat low for chair pose. Having a tuck in the tailbone, keep the chest lifted, heart open, shoulders relaxed. Weight is in the heels. Breathe. Sit a little bit lower. Reaching high through the fingertips. Take one more breath. And exhale, forward fold over straight legs. Inhale, halfway lift, lengthen. Exhale, plant the palms, step or hop back. Chaturanga Dandasana or knees, chest, chin. Inhale, up dog or cobra. Exhale, downward facing dog. Inhale, right foot steps between the hands. Ground down through the pinky side edge of the left foot. And rise up for your warrior one. Keeping a bend in the right knee. Breathe. Relaxing the shoulders. Take one more breath in. Reach through the fingertips. on the left.
On your inhale, stepping the left foot between the hands, grounding down through the pinky side edge of the right foot, and sweeping arms overhead for warrior one on the left. Moving. One more breath, reach. Exhale, palms to the mat, step back. Exhale, chaturanga or drop the knees. Up dog or cobra. Exhale, downward facing dog, stretch it out. Take two breaths. Inhale, up onto the toes. Exhale, bend the knees, look forward, step or hop, top of the mat. Inhale, half lift, lengthen the spine. Exhale, fold. Chair pose, inhale, sweep up and sit low. Breathe and settle in your chair, being okay with discomfort. One more breath. Let it go. Exhale. Inhale, stand, straighten the legs, reach the arms up. Exhale, hands to heart. Breath in and let it go. Inhale, sweep up and reach. Pull forward. Inhale, half lift, bend the knees. Time setting up a runner's lunge on the right. So stepping the left foot to the back of the mat, staying high on the ball of the left foot, keeping the right knee bent. Spine staying straight and long. Gaze a little bit in front of your back. Okay, just take a breath here. Setting up your foundation, a strong lunge position. And then planting the left palm to the floor or a block or a prop if you're at home, maybe a book, whatever you have, and reach the right arm to the ceiling, keeping the bend deep in the right knee. Knee is stacked over the ankle. Breathe. Release your twist, fingertips back to the mat, runner's lunge. Inhale, sweep it up, high lunge. Exhale. Inhale, straighten right knee. Exhale, open up, warrior two, re-bend the right knee, parallel to the back of the mat. Inhale, flip right palm. Exhale, reverse your warrior. Breathe. Inhale, back, warrior two. Exhale, cartwheel the palms to the mat. Step it back, high plank to lift up. Moving through vinyasa at your own pace. Up in downward facing dog. Deep breath in. And let it go. Inhale, up onto the toes. Exhale, bend knees, look forward, step or hop, top of the mat. Inhale. Exhale, forward fold. Inhale, rise up to stand. Arms reach. Exhale, fold. Bend the knees, setting on the left. Left foot forward, right foot back. Staying on the ball of the right foot. Fingertips into the mat. Spine is long. Just taking a few breaths in your foundational runner's lunge. Making sure that knee and ankle are in line. And then adding your twist. So right palm to the mat or to a prop to help you out. And left arm reaches up. Keep breathing. One more breath. And release your twist. two, open arms, open hips, right foot is parallel with the back of the mat. Inhale, flip left palm. Exhale, reverse your warrior. One breath here. Inhale, back warrior two. Exhale, cartwheel the palms, step it back, moving through your vinyasa or meet us right in down dog. Taking your time, there's no rush. Inhale, sweep right foot to ceiling. Exhale, pull knee to your nose, core plank. Inhale, foot to ceiling, three-legged dog. Exhale, knee to nose. One more, inhale, reach the right foot to the ceiling. Exhale, pull the knee to your nose. Step it through, drop left knee, untuck left toes, low lunge, sweep arms overhead. Breathe. Keep your breath moving in your twist. It's hard to. It's so important to. One more. Kind of raise your twist, come back to your low lunge, sweep the arms overhead. Exhale, fingertips to the mat. Tuck the left toes, lift left knee, runner's lunge. Take a breath here. We're coming to a standing split, but it's early in practice. It may not be really pretty. Mine really never looks like a standing split, so why not? Good. So straightening that right knee and pressing up off the floor, a little momentum forward, with your left foot as you ground your fingertips into the mat and fold your upper body over your standing leg. And just take a few breaths here, just warming up the hamstrings of that standing leg. Doesn't have to be cute. Returning to your runner's lunge, drop the ball of the left foot to the mat. And then setting up a wide-legged forward fold. So walking the hands over to the left. Inhale, lengthen. Exhale, fold. Hang out here for a couple breaths. You can move your hands however you'd like to. Maybe walking them behind you for more of a hamstring stretch. You can also grab your ankles or walk them out as if you're in a wide your attention. Take one more breath here. You move your hands, walk them back on the mat underneath your face. And inhale to lift. Exhale, walk the hands to frame the right foot, runner's lunge. Exhale, plant the palms, step it back, high plank to low plank, or drop the knees to modify. Inhale, upward facing dog. Exhale, downward facing dog, stretch it out. Take a breath here.
down, lift the left leg. Exhale, knee to nose. Step left foot between the hands. Low lunge. Drop right knee, untuck right toes. And take your time. Rise it up. Eventually, arms over the head. Take one more breath. Good. If you've moved your hands, bring them back underneath your face. And then walk to frame the left foot. And we'll set up that standing split on the left. So press off with the back foot, straightening the left knee and folding. Fingertips into the mat, aiming the nose towards the knee of your standing leg. Really lift up that right leg. Let the head hang heavy. Take one more breath. Good. And then drop right foot to the back of the mat, runner's lunge. Take a breath here. And then on your exhale, plant the palms, step it back, high to low plank. Move through vinyasa. Inhale, upward facing dog. Exhale, downward facing dog. Inhale, up onto the toes. Exhale, knees look forward, step or hop, top of the mat. Inhale, lengthen, flat back. Exhale, fold. Inhale, slowly rise up to stand, reach arms overhead, palms press. Exhale, hands to heart center. And take a breath here. And let it go. Palms at your sides, facing forward. Coming back to that intention. Inhale, sweep up, arms reach. Exhale, forward fold. Inhale, half lift, lengthen. Exhale, plant the palms, step or hop back. Chaturanga Dandasana or drop the knees. Inhale, up dog or cobra. Exhale, downward facing dog. Inhale, sweep right leg to the ceiling. Inhale, flip the front palm. Exhale, reverse your warrior.
Inhale, back to warrior two, straighten the right leg. Exhale, bump the hips back, reach forward, out and down. Pose. Never fail, my hip always cracks as soon as I do my first triangle. So. Still warming up. Continue your breath in your triangle. If you'd like to take on any other variation in your triangle, feel free to. As always, make it your own. Maybe reaching the arms overhead or taking a bind. But this is my favorite thing right here. One more breath. It's coming back up. Two, we bend the knee, breathe. And we'll set up half moon pose from here. So just like we pressed off to come into standing split with that back foot, we're going to press off. This time, keeping an open hip, so your left hip spins open to that side wall, keeping that left foot flexed, staying on the fingertips of the right hand. You can keep that hand to your left hip, to remind you to keep it open, or extend your hand to the ceiling. Breathe. If the bind is, feel free to take that bind. Deep breaths. If you fall out, get right back in. We don't call it a practice for nothing. One more breath. Release any binds you've gone on and come back to a standing split. So squaring the hips with the mat. So now feeling the difference between an open hip and a closed hip. So your left hip, the front of your left hip is pointing down towards the mat, relaxing the upper body over the right leg. Just breathe. Good. Then stepping that left foot about halfway on your mat into a pyramid pose. Inhale to a flat back. Exhale, forward fold. Hips stay square. Right toes are at 12 o'clock. Left toes have a slight turnout depending on your hips. Breathe. One more breath here. Bring the fingertips to frame the right foot. Bring a bend into the right knee. Step the left foot back to a runner's lunge just as a transition to help you get back to a high plank and either move through a vinyasa with your breath, or skip it and meet us right in down facing dog. Coming back to the breath here. Full, even breaths. On your next inhale, sweep left ceiling. Exhale. Four plank, step through, high lunge, sweep up. Exhale, open it up, warrior two. Inhale, flip left palm, reverse your warrior, exhale. Inhale, warrior two, arms, straighten left knee. Exhale, bump the hips back, reaching forward, out and down, triangle pose. Stay with the breath in your triangle. If you took on a variation on the other side, take it again. Take two more breaths. Completely on your inhale. hinging forward, straightening the left leg, opening the right hip to the right, maybe keeping that hand to the hip or extending it to the ceiling, flexing the right foot, really lifting that to the ceiling. Fingertips of the left hand are into the mat, or you can play with lifting them if that's part of your practice, and take the bind if that's part of your practice as well. Stay with the breath. Take two more. That opening. If you have the bind, gently release it. We'll come into a standing split. So fingertips to the mat, closing the right hip. So the front of the right hip is now pointing down towards the mat. The upper body over your standing leg. Just breathe. One more breath. Exhale. Drop the right halfway down your mat. The slight of the toes. Square off the hips, setting up your pyramid pose. Inhale, halfway lift, flat back. Exhale, fold forward, taking your time. Nose to knee. You don't have to touch, we're just aiming it in that direction. Breath moving. Take one more in your pyramid. And find a little bend in the left knee, stepping the right foot to the back of the mat, runner's lunge just as a transition, and planting the palms and coming back either to high plank to low plank, moving through your flow, up dog to down dog, or skip it and meet us there. Deep breaths. Take two more of your own full breaths in down dog. If you need child's pose, it's always here for you. Inhale up onto the toes. Exhale, bend the knees, look to the hands, step or hop, top of the mat. Inhale, lengthen, half lift. Exhale, forward fold. Inhale, slowly rise to stand, reach the arms overhead. Exhale, hands to heart center. Breath here. Empty out, letting it go completely. And then we'll set up eagle pose. So I'll turn to face you. Grounding down through the left foot first. We're going to bend deep into the knees, bringing the arms into a T. The more you bend your knees, the easier this is to set up. So bringing the right knee over the left. You can wrap this once, or if you can do a double wrap, bringing the toes around the ankle. Other knee, wrap over, wrap that elbow under. So right elbow under left elbow. Again, you can wrap once, just the elbows, wrapping twice, palms are touching each other. Breathe in your eagle, keep the bend in the knees, keep the core engaged, spine long and straight, lifting the elbows up. One more breath. And release it. Reach up, straighten the legs. Exhale, let it go. Hands at your sides, mountain pose. Getting ready to set up the other side. deep bend in the knees, weight in the right foot, pick up the left knee over right, dropping once or maybe twice, then bringing the left elbow and right elbow, wrapping once, the backs of the hands will touch, wrapping twice, the palms of the hands will touch. Breathe. One isn't better than the other. It's just working with your anatomy and with what you can do. So areas of tightness and resistance, at the same time working with those areas of mobility. Spine is long, core is engaged. Breathe. Length through the side body. One more. And release it. Reach up. And exhale. Hands to heart center. Deep breath in. Reach. Exhale. Forward fold. And find ragdoll. Separating feet or more. Taking opposite hands to opposite elbows, hang out. From here, taking gorilla pose, sliding the hands underneath the feet, palm face up. Shifting the weight slightly into the toes, really reaching the tailbone to the ceiling. Relax the head and neck. One more breath here. Release your hands from under your feet. Keep your wide stance, bringing your feet to the edges of your mat and turning out the toes, setting up for yogi squat. Inhale, lengthen the spine. On your exhale, bending the knees, sitting the seat between the toes, bringing the hands to heart center. This is a really good pose to use a block or a prop at home to slide it under your seat for a little support. Also, using your elbows for some leverage again, opening up the hips, the chest and the heart open and lifted. Breathing deep in this grounding posture. If crow pose is in your practice, and feel free to fly into your crow. I'm going to hang out right here and squat today. And just take three more deep breaths. To begin to out of your squat, bring the palms to the mat, straighten the knees, lifting the hips to the ceiling, and bringing the toes back to facing at 12 o'clock. Taking another gorilla pose, or just a regular ragdoll if that feels better for you. Breathe. Straightening out the legs, breathing into the backs of the legs, the back of the neck, and the low back. Good. If you took gorilla, release your hands. Heel toe your feet together. Inhale, half lift. Exhale, fold. Inhale, slowly rise up to stand. Take your time, reach the arms overhead. Exhale, bring the hands to heart. We'll take one tree pose for balance. So again, I'll turn to face you. Grounding down through the left foot. Picking up your right foot and bringing the right foot to the inner thigh, shin, or ankle of your standing leg. Just avoid the knee joint with your placement. to the ceiling, however you want your tree to look. Finding some length through the side, listening to your breath. And slowly release it, making your way out of your tree. Get the legs a little shake. And we'll set up the other side. So make it like your standing leg. Again, avoiding the knee with your placement. Pick it up. Engage your standing leg. Create that resistance. Bring the hands to heart to begin either hanging out right here or extending your arms to the ceiling. Listening to the sound of your breath. Begin to make your way out of your tree. Both feet plant into the mat. Bring your hands at your side. Shoulder roll breath. Inhale. Lift the shoulders towards your ears. Exhale, roll the shoulders down your back. Deep breath in, reach the arms to the ceiling. Exhale, forward fold. Inhale, halfway lift, lengthen the spine. Exhale, plant the palms, step or jump back, lower down. Chaturanga Dandasana or drop to modify. Inhale, forward and through. Upward facing dog or cobra. Exhale, lift the hips, lower the downward facing dog. Deep breath. And when you're ready, drop your knees to the mat and find child's pose. Toes together, knees are wide. Relaxing your upper body. Maybe the forehead touches, maybe it doesn't. That's okay. Just taking rest. Take two more deep breaths. One more. From here, slowly begin to make your way back to downward facing dog, and we'll set up pigeon pose. Beginning with the right leg lifting, inhale, sweep right leg to the ceiling. Exhale, pull right knee to nose, and then drop the right knee across the top of your mat. As parallel as you can get the shin. You can also take lying down pigeon to modify. Inhale, lengthen. Exhale, folding forward, taking your pigeon. Go. Maybe you stay on the palms, maybe coming down to the forearms. Maybe you can get your forehead to the mat. Just taking your time. Working with your breath. You don't have to come right into the full expression of the pose. You have time. Exhale to take you a little bit further. If you need to take lying down hip stretch, just lie down on your back, crossing the right ankle over the left knee, and then pulling the back of the left knee towards the body. Still getting a nice hip opener, just a little bit more gentle. So again, this is your practice. You take on whatever variation works best for you. Taking two more breaths in pigeon pose.
took lying down pigeon. You just hug your chest, roll around on the low back, and getting ready to set up your other side too. Beginning to set up the left side. Inhale, sweep the left leg to the ceiling. Exhale, pull knee to nose, and then bring the left shin across the top of the mat, keeping the left foot flexed. Inhale, lengthen the spine, sitting up tall. Exhale, folding forward. You're taking your pigeon, and each side may feel different. And be okay with that. Be patient. Be compassionate. We're never the same on each side, so one's always a little bit tighter than the other. My left side is definitely my tighter side. One more breath in your pigeon. And beginning to make your way out, slowly bringing the hands into the mat, lengthening the spine, sitting up tall, chest and heart open, breathe. And then rising the palms, tucking right toes, lift the left leg, stretch it out. Coming back to downward facing dog, taking on whatever stretches you need to. Pigeon poses. If you took lying down, hip stretch, knee to sit dog as well. Stretch out the legs. From your down dog, roll forward to plank pose. And either drop the knees, modify, or just bending the elbows and slowly lowering yourself down all the way to your stomach. Setting up locust pose for a back bend, bringing the chin on the mat, palms into the mat underneath the shoulder blades, elbows are pulling towards each other, close to the side body, zipping up the legs as if they're just one leg. Using your breath to set up your first back bend on your inhale, peeling the upper and the lower body up off the mat, engaging your back muscles to lift you. Breathe, keep your legs close and engaged. Maybe hover your palms off the mat. Take one more breath, lift. And lower down, resting one cheek to the mat. Relax your arms at your sides, palms facing the ceiling. Locust pose. You can take the same arm variation or switch it up if you'd like to take maybe airplane arms straight back behind you, arms in a T, arms out in front of you, or you could take a bind behind your low back for a little bit of a shoulder opener. I'm going to take a focus pose. But it's up to you. So bring your chin to the mat, set it up. Choose your arms. Zip up your legs, and on an inhale, lifting the upper body and the lower body off the legs up, peeling the chest up, lifting. Entire back body lifting you up off the mat. One more breath, lift. And gently lower to the mat. Finding rest, palms facing the ceiling. One more breath. Chin back to the mat, palms underneath your shoulders, and peeling yourself up for either a tall cobra, or if this is too
too much on your low back, just take baby cobra, keeping the elbows bent. This is fine too. You're still getting the back bent. So you choose your back. And breathe into it. Relax the glutes. Take one more breath. And from here, lowering back down the mat, chin to the mat. We're going to tuck the toes, and however you make your way up and back to downward facing dog, maybe moving through child's pose first, and then lifting back or pressing up through plank. Just straightening and lengthening the spine in your down dog after those back bends. Breathe. On whatever stretches and movements you feel you need. And when you're on your knees to the mat, taking one more child's pose, folding forward, breathing into that space that you're creating in your low back and in your hips. Take two more deep breaths here. One more. And then slowly make your way onto your seat. So you can get that long in front of you. Scooching your seat to the center of the mat if you've moved. I always tend to travel, so come back to the center of the mat. Reach your arms long in front of you and gently, with control, lower yourself onto your back. When you get there, hug your knees into your chest. Rolling out the spine, maybe rocking side to side or making little circles with the knees. If you're making circles, switch sides, switch directions. Keeping the right knee bent into the chest. And let you long onto the mat, arms in a T. Scoot your hips a little bit to the right, and then bring the right knee across the body, letting it fall to the left. Coming into your supine twist, gazing over your right shoulder. And let your eyes fall heavy, just soften the gaze here. Relax the breath. Coming back through center, unwind, scooch the hips back to the center of your mat, and extend your right leg long, then the left knee, then scooch the hips to the left, letting the left knee fall across the body to the right, and gaze over your left shoulder, relaxing into your twist, letting the eyes fall heavy, soften your gaze. Unwind, coming back to center. Hug both knees into your chest. Curl yourself into a ball. Maybe bring the forehead to the knees. Good. And then extending long onto your mat, reaching the arms overhead, pointing toes forward. Give yourself one long body stretch. Filling up your space. And then bring the soles of the feet onto the mat, bending at the knees. And then bring the soles of the feet together to touch. Knees falling open to the sides, coming into a
Sukta Baddha Konasana, recline one ankle. Bring one hand to your heart, the other hand to your stomach, so that one hand is on your heartbeat, the other is on your breath. Take at least 5 of your own deep breaths here. When you finish with your 5 breaths, you can either stay here and take your Shavasana in this position, or extend your legs long and bring your hands at your sides, palms facing the ceiling, letting your feet relax, setting up for Shavasana, your complete rest, relaxing your face and your jaw, the space between your eyebrows. Let your breath return to its natural flow. Just let yourself sink into the mat, feeling heavy and letting the floor fully support you. And stay in your Shavasana as long as you'd like. I encourage you to take a good long Shavasana. Enjoy your rest. You worked for it.